How do I use and clear Outlook.com contacts and autocomplete suggestions? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here again for askleo.com with another question about Outlook.com. Let's read it. I'm finding Outlook.com very annoying. How do I find the list of addresses and save a new one? When forwarding, I have to click through a whole load of addresses to get to the ones I want and then delete the ones that I didn't want. It wastes a lot of time. So let's walk through this. But before we start, I want to be very clear about something incredibly important. The term Outlook is used to mean two or three or four different things. This is Outlook.com. The website that you visit in your browser. This is not Microsoft Office's Outlook, the email program that gets installed on your computer. That's a different scenario. For now, we're looking at Outlook.com. Let's have a look. So here is Outlook.com. You can see I have a completely empty inbox and a lot of junk mail and even a draft in composing. You get the idea, right? This is Outlook.com, the website. It's redirected to outlook.live.com by the time you're finally signed in. First of all, where the heck are contacts? They move around from time to time. So the contact list is actually what they now call people. And that's what this little two-headed silhouette of a couple of people is all about. If I click on that, it now opens my contact list. I only have a couple, since this is an example account, but you get the idea. These are the people, the contact list, whatever you want to call it, associated with your Outlook.com account. And I can go back to my mail here by clicking on Mail. If you want to add people manually, go to your people and then click on New Contact. And then fill in the appropriate information for that contact, be it their email address, their names, whatever it is you care to add. In my case, I'm happy with the two that I've got. So I'll click on the email icon there to go back to my inbox. So, sending email to someone in your contacts. Well, we'll hit new message. And now, what a lot of people don't realize is that this two here is actually a button. And it will bring up your contacts list and let you pick who it is you want to send your email to. You can click on the plus sign and it will add that person. You can click on more than one person to add them to the to line. Or if you decide, nah, I didn't really want to, you can click on the X here or the X here and it'll remove that item from the to line. But once you've built your list of contacts that you want to have this message sent to, just click save. And now the message has a to line. Now, the other thing that tends to confuse people is what I'll call the autocomplete list. And this is actually a combination of what's in your address book and a few other things. If I start typing ask, you can see it's coming up with the items that were available on my contacts list. If I wanted to remove them from the suggestion, all I really needed to do is go over here and click on the little X. And that'll remove it from the suggestions it's presenting. You can see that this is actually a combination of two email addresses, one that was from my address book, but one that isn't. This is a completely different email address. It had nothing to do with my address book. It did not come from contacts. Where it came from is that I sent mail to it previously. In another iteration, in another example probably, I sent a piece of email to this askleotest@gmail.com. Outlook.com saved that. They saved that in the autocomplete list. Now, if I want that to be gone, all I really need to do is click the X here and it's no longer in the offerings. But if I start over now with a new message and I start typing ask, you'll see that it's no longer offered as a suggestion. We actually removed it from the suggested contacts or from the suggestions that it's making as I type in. Now, unfortunately, Outlook.com has made changes over the years. Many changes over many years. One of the changes that it made sometime recently is that there is no way to, I'll just say, control or turn off these autocomplete features. Outlook.com is going to make suggestions whether you want it or not. The best thing you can do is to carefully control what you have in your contacts list, in other words, over in People, and judiciously use the little remove X box here on the suggestions that happen to come up to remove them from autocomplete suggestions in the future. And finally, yeah, I did say Outlook.com changes. It's going to change again. Don't know how, don't know when, don't know how it's going to impact what we've just discussed, but be aware that change is the only thing that never changes when it comes to Outlook.com. And what I've described here may change a little bit. It may change a lot. Be flexible. Be a little inquisitive. Do a little bit of searching. Once you're familiar with how the feature works today, hopefully you'll be able to understand and locate how it works when they make changes in the future. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/106-29. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.